Okay, so you guys, like I said, you're ninth grade students.
So you know ninth grade, you got like new environment, new people, you're experiencing different things. So you'll probably be in a situation where peer pressure is around you. So the first thing I want you guys to do on your sheet of paper, we're going to define peer pressure and what that means to you. And you're going to list three things of ways that you can be negatively affected by peer pressure. So I don't want these to necessarily be super informative, so kind of keep it confidential. Don't throw anybody's name in there. But just kind of give some ways that you've been affected. I'll give you a minute or so. You're ninth grade, going through changes, new friends. Like we did earlier, when you're done, just put your pencil down. Never peer pressure? Come up with something. Use your imagination. More seconds. All right, we'll go ahead. So can someone give me your definition of what peer pressure is? Sarah.
Peer pressure is when someone about your age wants you to do something you didn't want to do.
That they wanted you to do, right?
Once you...
Right, yeah. Okay, that's good. What are the three ways? Jim?
Alcohol.
Alcohol. So is alcohol a peer pressure?
No. So people, tell you...
So that's just the way that people kind of... You get peer pressure if you drink alcohol.
Okay. Yeah. I was negatively peer pressured and then taking my parents' car for a joyride.
Okay. That's probably not the best, but...
Yeah, one of my friends tried to get me to smoke a cigarette with him after school.
Okay, yeah, so all these, right, you're looking at these are like negative peer pressures, right?
You said negative.
Well, they are, but I'm just saying that peer pressure also is not only, there's positive and negative. So, we'll go over that in a little bit. First thing we're going to do, though, I'll kind of give a definition of what like peer pressure is. We'll talk about the different types of peer pressure and then ways to avoid it, all right? So, the definition of peer pressure. So it's pressure from one of your peers to do something that they want you to do, right? So as you get older, you're going to want to do things. People are going to press you to do these things. And the person who's doing the pressure generally knows what they're doing is not right. But they want you to do it. That way they don't feel so bad about themselves and so that they feel more comfortable. So when you're getting pressure from somebody, that comes like a strength in numbers thing. And if they can get you and they think you're like a good kid, and they're like, well, if he's doing it, that doesn't make me look bad. So it's like a peer pressure that's influenced in your social group, so it's like people that are around. All right, so different types of peer pressure. Does anybody have an idea what negative peer pressure is? Yes.
Something to
do that you think would be bad. Okay, and then direct negative peer pressure.
Someone telling you, hey, I'm doing this, you should do it too.
Right, so this is like an applied thing. So like an example would be you're in class, someone brings a water bottle of vodka, they're like, hey, drink it. You're like, I don't want to drink it. But they stick with you and they're like, no, you need to drink it, or you're not cool, lame, those type of things. What about indirect? Right, so like this wouldn't necessarily be like alcohol or the drugs, but like let's say you have a school dress code and like all your friends are wearing lower cut, if you're a girl, they're wearing lower cut clothes and you're like, I don't want to show that much skin because that's what you think, but you're also like, I want to be cool. And you think those are the girls that are doing it, they're cool, so that if you want to be cool, that's what you have to do. And then positive peer pressure. So what would be a positive peer pressure example?
So my friend, we were at a party and yeah. She wasn't drinking, so therefore she kind of positively peer pressured me and was like, we don't need to drink, so we kind of
stuck together, like a buddy system.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, we'll talk about that in a minute.
Sometimes my friends will invite me over to study.
Study with them. Okay, yeah. So that's a really good one. I kind of use that in an example later. what, like, if you could have somebody that can, like, there's a negative thing you could do, and then they can twist it into a positive thing, kind of pressure you to do that, that'd be kind of a good thing to do. That'd be an example of positive peer pressure. So, we're going to watch this short video. This video basically kind of summarizes everything that I kind of talked about already, and then it kind of gives some information on different ways to alleviate that peer pressure. So just pay attention that there's like seven different topics or seven different strategies that you can use. So just kind of pay attention to that, and we'll talk about those when it's over. Say, well, I wasn't there, so you can just always put that. Yes, sir.
But then I become uncool if I'm not there.
maybe in your, you can, in short side, you think you're uncool, but in the long term, right, those people aren't the people you want to be around with. Maybe in that little moment you feel uncool, but that's not really an accurate. Anyway, say no, right? So we want to say no, be repetitive, be strong with it. You don't want to kind of say, oh, no. Be like, no, I'm not doing it. You know, it's not that hard, but when you kind of sound weak about it, you kind of seem susceptible. If they keep after you, they might believe that they can actually get you to say yes. Also, be repetitive. So if you do say no, say it again. Like, don't let them back you down into a corner and then make you do it. And then use the buddy system. So like that trustee, right? Have someone that's got the same morals as you. Have someone that has like the very strong will, strong-minded, that's kind of gonna have your back in a situation where you're in a tough spot. And then look for positive role models / friends. So as ninth grade, right, y'all are coming into a situation where you're in a new school, you can develop new friends, people come and go all the time. If you can find the people that are right for you and have the same type of beliefs and morals that you do, those are the better people to hang out with. And also look for like older people to kind of be like role models for you. And then eventually, when you get up to being older, you can be a role model for other younger kids as they get into high school. And then evaluate your friendships. If you have people that are, if you notice that you're the people you're with, they're the ones applying peer pressure, they're creating situations that are uncomfortable for others, and you're the ones that are kind of causing, I wouldn't say harm, but you're not doing the right thing all the time, you might want to find new friends. Because like I said, you're changing, things can happen, and it's just best to find better people to hang out with than to find others that might get you in trouble to wait. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to pass out this worksheet, and it's got some scenarios on it. So we'll kind of split you guys into groups. We'll let you three be in a group. You'll have number one. You guys can have number two. You and Britton. And y'all can have number three. What I want you to do, I want you to explain or list what type of peer pressure is being shown. And then I want you to state some strategies on how you can avoid these situations.
Can we see the types again?
You can see the types, yes. Of like ways to, or different types of pressure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Jackson is living 10 years, by the time they're reporting their alcohol will be present. Give a couple to your parents to see if they're going to attend. When they pick up, they say, not there, and they have a message to just stay home and watch out. You can come over and watch the game. What type of peer pressure is
that? At first, they know, is it persistent and keeps pressuring you to drink more? What type of pressure is that?
You got 30 more seconds.
We just necessarily have to go watch hockey just to get to the part. But like going to watch the hockey and spend
a lot of good on time. Mark Wallace pocket for her.
Gotta sneak it around, man. Someone that's hanging around. I don't know. You guys let me know. I'm not in high school anymore.
I'm only in ninth grade.
You're only in ninth grade. You're skipping.
How's pocket?
Let's get that later. Are we all done? All right, scenario one. Someone read me y'all scenario, please.
Jackson and his buddy Teddy are invited to a Halloween party where alcohol will be present. You give a call to your friend to see if they are going to attend. When they pick up, they say, nah, man, I think I'm just going to just stay home and watch hockey. You should come over and watch the game with me. What type of peer pressure is shown?
Okay, so what type of peer pressure is shown?
We said indirect, negative pressure, and positive peer pressure.
Okay, why would you say that? An indirect?
Because they were invited to the party where alcohol was, so
okay.
That's indirect, negative. And all then right. The positive peer was when you call your friend and they are not going to watch the game.
Okay, so what are the ways that you could avoid that situation?
The whole situation?
Well, just the indirect negative.
Well, you shouldn't be friends with the people who are going to the party, I guess.
Okay.
But to avoid going to the party, you can either just stay at home or go to your friend's house and watch the hockey game.
You don't necessarily have to not be friends with those people. You just don't have to necessarily do what they're doing. You don't have to just, like, shut them off. But I guess sort of when you do friends, you don't necessarily, you're not best friends, I guess. Right? You don't have to do everything together. All right, that's good. Number two.
Janice is over at her friend's house for a sleepover with 8 other girls. Yep, this is us. The girls are passing her a water bottle full of vodka. Each girl so far has taken a drink from the bottle, and you are next in line. The girls are forcing you to drink, but you don't want to. Oh, the girls aren't forcing you to drink, but you don't want to appear lame. What type of peer pressure is shown? What strategy would you use to alleviate the pressure?
All right, so what pressure is shown?
So we said indirect negative.
Okay, why?
Because they're not like forcing us and they're not telling us, but it's just kind of getting passed around, so you're just in the circle.
Mm-hmm.
So
what would be like a potential problem? Like what, or an internal problem that you're having if you don't do it?
If I don't do it, then I could look lame.
Okay. All right.
What
are some ways you can alleviate that pressure?
So we said we would act like we took a drink, but not all really.
Right. All right. That's the best, but all right.
But and we also said we could just say no. But there's, you know, if you don't want to stand out. Maybe.
Right.
You could just pass it.
I think a good idea in that situation.
Well, that's what you do. You basically you act like you're
right.
And
well,
not really.
Yes, but I think something that would be beneficial in this situation, anytime you go into a party like or a sleepover, right, you should know that there's going to be potential for something, maybe not drinking, but something where bad things might happen. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of important to, if you're going, have somebody that you know that's also going, that's willing to kind of stand up. And so you kind of, like I said, strengthen numbers earlier. Mm-hmm. You kind of strengthen numbers here where it's like, okay, well, we're not going to do it. So that necessarily, you know, you both feel better about your decision.
My trustee is everywhere.
You need to have a good trustee. That's important. All right, situation three.
Roberto and his friends are tailgating in the parking lot before the football game. One of his friends, Miguel, stole a 12-pack of beer from his parents' house and is passing them around to your friends. Miguel tries to get you to drink, but at first you say no. He's persistent and keeps pressuring you to drink one. What type of pressure is shown and what strategy you can use?
Okay, so what type of pressure is here?
Negative peer pressure.
Negative peer pressure, is it direct or indirect?
Direct.
Direct. How is he being direct?
He keeps asking you to drink even though you told him no.
Right, so he's real persistent. Okay, so how could you alleviate that?
You could stick with like the repetitive no.
Okay.
Or you could leave the situation.
Right, yeah, I think that one's really important. You could just, I mean, if you're tailgating, there's probably other friends there. You could go, or you could just go to the game, right? So, I mean, in most of these situations, I think the best way to avoid them is just to avoid them altogether. If you're not there, you're not being the one to be pressured. So if you're not in that situation, then you can always just, so y'all did really well. So you understand it, but unless you don't, we're gonna kind of go over some couple of things. So on your sheet, I want you to give a revised definition of peer pressure. Could be the same if you got it right. And then I want you to give the four different types of peer pressure. Kind of three, it's four and three, but. And then the last thing I want you to do, list some ways that you can deal with these pressures. Just like list two or three. And once you're done, we'll put it down and we'll go. What's the time?
That it?
Well, it could be.
It's 19 minutes, so you're good. Were you gonna ask him?
I was gonna ask him.
Yeah, go ahead and ask him. Just go ahead.
Okay, so what are peer pressures? Gary?
Peer pressure is someone directly or indirectly trying to force me to do something I do not want to do.
Okay.
That they do want.
Huh?
That they do want. They want you to do it.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And they, yes.
Okay. No answer.
All right.
I would done that.
Yes. What are the different types of peer pressure? Corey?
You have negative and positive, but each of them having direct and indirect.
Correct. Okay. That's kind of where I didn't know if it was confusing at first. And then what are some ways that you can deal with these pressures?
Say Say no.
Say no.
Trustee.
Trustee. Trustee. What
situation.
Else?
Situation.
Other trustee.
Yeah? All right, good. All right, thank you.